I feel like for me, it has been a turning point in my career because I did not see this kind of success through Kota. And it was also the first black and white show in India. So to be a part of that kind of legacy, I think I've been very grateful like that. Hi, I'm Ehsaas Chana and you're watching me on Bollywood Live.
Hello, Bollywood Life viewers. I am Sanskriti. And today we are in conversation with Kota Factory star Ehsaas Chana.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So you have been working since you were a child and now you know, you have been doing so many projects and people exactly know what Ehsaas is doing. How does it feel?
Oh, it feels very nice because you know, as an actor, I feel like everybody wants to do this. Everybody wants everyone to know you. So that's what's happening. And at this point, I feel like people know me by name. So at that, when that happens, when people come and call you by your name and know exactly what you're doing or talks to you very precisely about your project, I think that is very important for every actor. And I think I really like it when that happens, when people are just not like, oh, you're an actor, whatever. They come and talk to you about a project. So I think that's
true. And Kota Factory has touched many hearts and it has been special for so many people. So how special is this for you?
I feel like for me, it has been a turning point in my career because I did not see this kind of success through Kota at all in the first place. Like I remember auditioning for it when in 2018 and I had no idea what Kota is. Like I only knew it's a city in Rajasthan, but I did not know that, you know, students go there, kids go there and prepare for IIT and it's such a difficult course or whatever. I did not know any of that. So I was introduced to this world, and when that happened, when I understood the, you know, the mathematics of how things work there, I was completely shocked. And I, just to be a part of a show that's done so well, and it was also the first black and white show in India, so to be a part of that kind of legacy, I think I've been very grateful like that.
True. So what does Ehsaas take away from Shivangi?
I really like Shivangi's character because she's a badass and I'm not. So every time I get to play Shivangi, I'm excited because I get to play something that I'm not. I'm very confident. She's a very confident girl. She's very positive. She's the Agni auntie of the group. And she's giving this really cool advice to everybody. Everybody's coming to her for advice. And nobody comes to me for advice. Everybody, I'm the worst advice giver. I go to people. So to play a character that I'm not, I think I'm always very, very excited to.
Okay. So when we talk about Kota Factory, Jitu Bhaiya has become an important part because har kisi ko unke jaisa ek mentor chahiye. So how close is Jitu Bhaiya to you, and how has it been working with Jitendra Kumar?
You know, I've not had too many scenes with Jitu Bhaiya in the show because I am preparing for NEET and he's an IIT teacher. So I don't have too many scenes with him. So I have not been able to like spend that much time with him. But I get to spend time with him when we are promoting the show. So all three seasons we've only met during promotions. So, but I think he's amazing and he's also a very nice person. So it's always nice to be around him. And I think he's done a phenomenal job. The reason why Jitu Bhaiya is such a hit is because he's done such a good job at playing Jitu Bhaiya.
True. So do you have someone like Jitu Bhaiya in your life?
My mother is my Jitu Bhaiya. I go to her for everything. She's the one who's taught me acting. She's the one who's groomed me. She's very, very involved in my career, in my journey. And she's the best advice giver. So she's my Jitu Bhaiya.
Yeah, definitely she has raised a beautiful woman. And how does it feel like, how does it feel to her when she sees you as the star?
She doesn't see me as a star yet, like at all. I mean, I don't think I'm also a star either, but she's always, I think she's the one who knows, who is very proud of me, who loves me and who supports me and who's actually very proud. But she's, I think, somebody who doesn't want it to get to me, you know. So she's the one who always keeps me grounded and she's like, haan, theek hai, achha hai, bahut badhiya, but aur mehnat karni hai, aur kaam karna hai, aur ye karna hai, isko sar pe nahi leke jana hai. We have to be grounded, we have to be disciplined. So she's, I think she's aware of everything and she's very happy for me. And but my constant, there's always this constant need of making her proud, and I think I will constantly work hard for that.
You're doing it. Also, you have played so many characters since your childhood. You have, you know, mostly we have seen you as a boy and then you growing up into such a beautiful lady. And when you were small, there were rumors that you were a girl and you were a boy and you converted to a girl. Did these rumors affect you?
Oh, not at all. It didn't actually come to me only because I was so young and my mom only dealt with all these rumors.
Yeah.
And so she didn't let it, like, I did not know of it at all. I was just doing my job. I was a very happy child who, I loved shooting. I loved being on set. I loved acting. So I was just doing my job and she dealt with everything. But I think it's clear now. I mean, there will always be these kind of rumors and all these kind of conversations around people who are like, oh, she's a girl. Oh, no, she's a boy. Oh, no, she's a girl. I think it's a good thing only that it keeps you, people are talking about you. So it's a good thing only.
Okay. Also, you've worked with so many big actors at a young age. So do you remember something, like anything that will always stay with you?
I remember shooting for Kabhi Alvidana Kehna and we were all like, it was a huge star cast. It was the biggest star cast and I was a part of that project. And I got to stay with all these people, like all the stars in the same hotel because we were shooting in New York for 2 months. So we were all in the same hotel. So we would bump into each other a lot. And despite not having a scene with Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, I bumped into him a couple of times. There was this Diwali party that I had gone to and I remember him telling me that I have a long way to go. So that stayed with me and that is like the core, like that's core memory for me because Amitabh Bachchan telling you this is a huge thing and that has stayed. So every time I feel like a little insecure or I feel like low whatever, I always think of this moment where Amitabh Bachchan said that you have a long way to go. So I keep working hard, don't give up because you have a long way to go. If Mr. Bachchan said it, then you better get your game together.
Did you meet someone like from with you whom you work?
I very recently met Karan Johar and I was so happy because I knew that I was going to meet him. It was at an event he was hosting and we had to go on stage. So I knew that he's going to, like, we're going to meet. But I was just constantly worried and I remember telling everybody ki, what if he doesn't remember me? I need to go remind him because I was convinced that he doesn't remember who I am. But the funny thing is that as soon as I went on stage, he was the one who hugged me and he said that I'm so happy to meet you, Ehsaas. And he on stage said that, okay, I've worked with Ehsaas in Kabhi Alvidana Kehna. And I was so happy and shocked that he remembers me and he was so just humble about it. And then we went backstage, we spoke a little and so that was amazing.
Great. Okay. So, you know, you have a lot of projects to go on in future. Tell us something about that.
I have Half CA season 2 coming up because we're shooting for it. We're shooting for the second season. We announced it on CA Day, which is 1st of July. And the response was amazing. Just like people were just very happy that a season 2 is coming up. So I know looking at the response, I'm hoping that the show also does very well. And there's Mismatch season 3. I joined the cast in season 3. There was one scene of mine in season 2 which did really well and that's when the writers decided ki, okay, let's write this more and turn this into an arc, and that's what's happening in season 3 and I'm very excited, looking forward to it.
Okay, so we ended with a rapid fire related to social media, okay?
Okay, go for it.
So, one social media hack.
My social media hack is to understand your algorithm because there are certain times in the day where if you post, it reaches more people. So like I have that time, if I post at that time, the engagement is better. So that is my hack.
So what is that time?
It's 12, 3, 6, 9. I have 4 time.
Okay, how to make a reel viral?
I really don't know, man. I genuinely don't know. Like I feel like at this point, like social media is so unpredictable. Anything can go viral and something that you think will go viral doesn't go viral. So it totally depends on, I feel like at this point, just be yourself and do whatever, just have fun on social media.
Okay. One Instagram account that you stalk?
I stalk Hailey Bieber, I stalk Kendall Jenner, Gigi Hadid for fashion inspos because I really like the rest.
Okay. So which celeb has the best Insta according to you?
I feel Shraddha Kapoor has the best Instagram because she's so herself. She's not made up, she does whatever, I feel like she's very relatable when it comes to, she's just like one of us. Being the biggest star, I feel like the way she talks and her captions and her choice of like photos to post, I think it's just, she's very authentic, which I really like about her social media.
And one account which you think should improve?
Mine. I am constantly trying to work on my account because there are times where I feel like I post a little too much. Then I feel like, no, I'm not very regular, consistent. So like, I feel like my social media needs a lot of working.
Okay. So how to handle trolling?
I don't know. Again, I am somebody who has not, I don't deal with trolling or with hate comments very well. So what I do is I don't look at them only. Ignorance is bliss. That's what I believe in. So don't look at your trolls and just like ignore as much. Because the good part about trolling and the cancel culture is that it dies down very soon. Like it's a phase. Like people don't remember itna. Like people forgive you also very easily. So I think that is a good thing. So just for that phase where you're getting trolled or something is up, you're not liking it, people are not appreciating it, I think you can just wait and not look at it and then it dies down and then you're okay. So, yeah.
This is the best one. So any message for youngsters, you know, who want to be influencers, who want to grow up, you know, through their social media?
I think just understand your niche, understand what you want to do and just do your best at it. If it has to work out, if it's meant to be for you, it will happen. Just give your 100% so that you don't regret later that, oh, I didn't even try this or I wanted to really do this, but something stopped me. I think you should give it a shot. Give a shot to everything you want. Try everything out and see what works for you. And if you work hard, I think it'll always pay off.
Definitely. So thank you so much for your time. And I completely enjoyed this.
I also had a great time talking to you.
Thank you to our viewers. Stay tuned to Bollywood Life.